Hi, this is Matt Lammers with the Cayman Compass. I'm here with Jonathan Piercy, who is running with the CDP in the constituency of Georgetown West. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Matt, for having me. I grew up in Georgetown West. My history, the Piercy history, is very deep in Georgetown West. I grew up at the Piercy Square, was located off of Goring Avenue in a little hamlet, and I've just sort of always been in the Georgetown West area. I am from Pond Road, which is off of Smith Road. In addition to that, I think that I have something to offer Georgetown West because that is a very strong working middle class constituency, and there are a lot of issues facing the middle class generally in the Cayman Islands, and I do believe that when I'm elected, I'll have something to offer, not just the people of Georgetown West, but the people of Grand Cayman.
Thank you. What are the most important issues facing your constituency?
The most important issue right now facing my constituency are issues surrounding the aging population in Georgetown West. There are a number of elderly persons who are having difficulty finding food, keeping a roof over their head, and taking care of prescription medication. I think that there's another issue, another problem going on amongst our youth as well. Many of our kids are going to school hungry. Some of them are certainly not performing well. There is no technical and vocational program in place. And I think that what is very discouraging is that in many instances, when they do come back home from abroad after receiving their education, there's still not enough opportunity for gainful employment. So there's two things, really two challenges. You asked for one, but I'm giving you two, the youth and the elderly. And I'm hoping to pay attention to those specific areas.
Thank you. What are the most important issues facing Cayman as a whole?
I think the most pressing issue right now facing Cayman is the whole issue of foreclosures amongst Caymanians. I do believe that both in 2015, 2016, we've seen some of the highest numbers of foreclosures amongst Caymanians. I also believe that that is an indication of the state of the economy. If we look at what happened in 2008, for example, in the United States of America, we'll see that the housing crisis was what really shook their economy, and I am afraid that what we're seeing in Cayman is a precursor to a worsening economy, especially amongst the working middle class.
What's something that's going right in Cayman, and what would you do to continue it?
I think what's actually going right in Cayman is what we're seeing happening by and large in our tourism industry. If you look at the numbers for stay over tourism, we'll see that those numbers have increased significantly over the last several years. I am quick to say, however, that much of the plans that have resulted in these positive numbers, this growth, were plans that were put in place when the UDP administration was there. I would certainly continue to support those plans and grow the industry, with the caveat that more Caymanians need to participate in the hospitality and tourism industry.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If elected, what's your priority on day one?
On day one, I think the number one priority on day one is to take care of all of those issues. On day one, we need to figure out a way, certainly to take care of our elderly. They have to be able to find food for themselves, provide for themselves. We have to provide, as a society, some sort of housing or affordable housing for our youth, for our elderly. And in addition to that, we definitely need to make sure that prescription drugs are going to be accessible and available to our elderly. With respect to the youth, we definitely need to have a technical and vocational school in place. We need to make sure we have more apprenticeship programs in place. And we need to make sure that there's greater involvement and inclusion with our Caymanians in the economy. If we do that, Matt, then we no longer have to ask the question, who are we developing for? The right answer would be, we're developing for our people. So I believe that is a top priority, and simultaneously, we must address the high numbers of foreclosures amongst Caymanians.
Thank you, Mr. Piercy.
Thank you very much for having me, Matt, and I just want the listening, those of you who are watching, to know that you can find more information on me. My webpage, jonathanpiercy.org, or on Facebook, Jonathan Piercy GT, or you can call me on my telephone number, which is 926-1663. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Once again, this is Matt Lammers with the Cayman Compass. Thank you for watching.